Larry, men from my community, shame on you! Yeah. Yeah. You are a disgrace to the Pakistani community. You come here tooled up. The police officers knew what was happening right from the onset. These Pakistani men were not here to protest. They came tooled up to cause a fight. The police officers are totally to blame. You could have stopped this right from the onset. This is a political rally. We have the right to have a political rally. The Pakistani men have no right to come here and attack young kids in the crowd by throwing bricks and balls. Shame on the Pakistani community. Yes. And I say this to the chief constables, and I say this to the media. Present one evidence that this man is a racist. Present one evidence to me that this man is a far right, and I will turn against him. Present one evidence, and that evidence has to be audible, and I want to see him audibly saying racist things. If there's any evidence of that, I will speak against him. I will not stand here with a racist man. The reason why I am here, because he is not a racist, and I'm sick of tired of an innocent man being labelled a far right and a racist just because he speaks the truth about the men from my community that have raped white kids across 78 towns. That is raising community tensions. The men from my community are the most racist people that I can think of. I know. I was born into it. I was fed the racism that I was raised up in. White girls this, white girls that. That is racism. This is not racism. This is fighting against hate. Pakistani men, where is your bestie? Where is your sharm? Where is your bestie? Hang your head in shame and go home. Go home.
We specifically chose to come here rather than anywhere near the Muslim community. We chose here rather than in the city centre so that it would not be said that we're provoking a reaction. We chose the safest place in Oldham that we could come and have a campaign rally. That gang of masked hooligan thugs were walked here by the police. We have seen in this campaign rally every single measure and every stop they could do to ruin it. Now they've provoked and allowed riots so that the headlines won't say that they come and attacked us. The headlines won't say that we had children and families on the campaign rally to exercise our democratic rights. The headlines won't say that. The headlines are saying that we've stirred up tensions and we've stirred up trouble and it's our fault. That's what the headlines are saying. To every single person who's just watching the evidence and the videos of what has happened here today, what do you think it's going to be like in the future? What do you think it's going to be like in every town and city across our country? Already now, we can't have campaign rallies. Already now. We don't want violence. We don't want trouble. The only way we can fight this is through the ballot box. Let's start that revolution on the 23rd of May. Everyone who's here, anyone who's been injured or anyone who knows anyone who's hurt, I generally believe the police are asking and asking and asking that I leave. They think that it will quell the tensions once it's been made public that I leave. We're in the middle of a housing estate with lots of innocent families and children. I know you're all here. I'm trying to work out how everyone's going to get away. How are you all going to get out of it? We've got children. Children having bricks and bottles thrown at them by gangs of Muslim youth. All we're trying to do is hold an election campaign rally. We have specifically chosen not to go into the city centre. We specifically chose not to go near any Muslim estates in order for there to be no trouble. And still, they've come to these estates. They've come out of their areas and come to attack our campaign rally in a non-Muslim area.
still. Watch the media. Watch the media only focus on our behaviour. Watch the media try and spin this completely.
This is a non-Muslim community. They have allowed Muslims to come and violently attack it. Violently indiscriminate against women and children. Women have been violently beaten. Imagine what the world and our country would say if the Muslim community were having a campaign rally and hundreds of white masked men turned up and beat up their women and threw bricks at them. Imagine what people would say. This is not right. It should not be allowed to happen. This is not the country we want to live in. I think, to be honest, the longer I stay here, the longer they're going to stay here. As it gets into the evening, the last thing we want is them not rioting across the city. So I'm going to make the decision. I'm going to leave. I'm going to love you all. I'm going to thank you all.
We love you, Tommy.
I'm going to say,
thank you
for coming, man.
I'm sorry
that the way this has been policed has allowed that. I'm sorry that there's members of this. In fact, it's not members of this town. They've travelled from everywhere. Apparently, I've just heard online they've got Halifax Pakistanis. They've come from everywhere, they have. They've come from everywhere to kick off and cause violence. And the worst thing is, all the intelligence was there online. All the people inciting it were online. But I think the best thing, so that there's less disorder, is for me to leave. So thank you.